Firefox 140 steps up as the 2025 ESR release, while Firefox 141 is also promising performance benefits by having more efficient RAM use on Linux going forward. And also, we got a little bit of a bummer news from Mozilla, sunsetting its DeepSpeech voice engine. We'll talk about that in a second. So let's talk about what is happening in the latest release of Firefox 140, because this is the latest extended support release, or ESR, which guarantees one full year of maintenance for risk-averse organizations or the long lifespan style distros like Debian. So this will be superseding the Firefox 128 ESR, and it also starts the clock for the eventual retirement of this September for the 115 ESR. So the standout new tricks for this release of Firefox is the ability to right-click a tab and then choose to unload that tab, freeing up memory instantly, which is very cool. A lot of other browsers have that too, so it's nice to see Firefox is now adding that sort of feature. Also, vertical tabs get a resizable pin zone. So if you want to have, like, you can basically control how many or how it does the pins of the various different applications or various different websites inside of that section rather than just however it happened to do it before. So that's pretty cool. Also, adding custom search engines is now just two quick clicks away. And of course, Pocket has now started to see removal from the new tab integration, as well as the pocket button in the toolbar, since the service is winding down. Now let's talk about a sneak peek for the next release of Firefox, with Firefox 141 beta promises to use less memory on Linux systems and no longer require a forced restart after package manager update, which is pretty nice. So having the ability to get improved performance with less RAM usage is definitely something I am looking forward to with 141. Now for some bummer news is that Mozilla is formally discontinuing its open source DeepSpeech project, which is a speech to text engine, after years of inactivity. So unfortunately, it hasn't seen much development since 2021, and there hasn't been a release since 2020. So it's not surprising, but it also is still disappointing, because having an open source speech to text engine, it was always something that I was super excited that Mozilla was working on, and now they're not, so that's a bummer. So what are your thoughts on the latest release of Firefox? Are you excited about this release? Are you excited about the next one, 141? Or are you just disappointed by all the changes and the things that Mozilla keeps killing? Let me know in the comments what you think.